In this session, we will discuss how you can add React Bootstrap in your project. So now we are adding React Bootstrap and normal Bootstrap, both. Okay. So React Bootstrap is means that library which provided by the React. And here we have Bootstrap library. Bootstrap. Now we are trying to add React Bootstrap and Bootstrap both library in our React project. How we can start? Okay, watch here. So open the terminal window in VS Code, and here we type the command npm. So now we install npm install. What we want to install? React Bootstrap. React Bootstrap space, and we want to add Bootstrap, normal Bootstrap also. So npm install the React Bootstrap, and also it will install the normal Bootstrap. Okay, just press enter. And now watch here, it will start the downloading Bootstrap in your project. So now you can check here your packages is installed in your project. So Bootstrap is installed in your project. So how you can check whether Bootstrap is installed or not installed? Go to the package.json file. So now we open package.json file. And now watch here in the dependency sections. Check the dependency section. In the dependency section, we have Bootstrap. This is a Bootstrap and React Bootstrap. Now both dependencies are here now in mentions. This means Bootstrap is installed in your project. Bootstrap, which version? 5.11 version. And React Bootstrap, which version? 1.63. So now React Bootstrap and Bootstrap both are installed in your system. So whatever dependencies mentioned in package.json, these dependencies are installed in under node underscore module folder. So open the node underscore module folder, and you can search here Bootstrap folder. So you can search here Bootstrap folder. Bootstrap folder. Yeah, you can search this folder Bootstrap. Okay, watch here, this Bootstrap folder. So now Bootstrap is installed. Now you can expand this folder. Once you expand, you got one folder, distinct folder. Now again, for expand this folder, you have CSS folder. And expand the CSS folder, watch here. Under CSS folder, you have, watch here, this Bootstrap classes. So actually we are using Bootstrap min.css. So whether it's a Bootstrap min.css. Okay, Bootstrap. So Bootstrap install under which folder? Under node underscore module folder, we have Bootstrap folder. Under Bootstrap, we have distinct folder. And then under we have CSS folder. Under this CSS, we have different version of Bootstrap. Okay, once you install the bootstrap, now we want to use bootstrap in our project. So let's try to understand. Now we are testing bootstrap in our project. So here we have app component. So in the app component, now we are using bootstrap component. But before using bootstrap component, open the index.js file. In this file, we have required to import the bootstrap. So now we import the bootstrap. So here we are importing bootstrap. Under bootstrap, we have folder Disney folder. Under Disney folder, we have CSS folder. From that, we are importing bootstrap.min.css files. So we are importing these files. And now come into the app.js files. Now here we are using the bootstrap. So let's say we are using any component, bootstrap component. Okay, just we create a button here and check. In the app component, here we creating one simple button. Now, here we create one button. And now close the button. And here we writing the button. Here you can write login. Now we are using the button. So when we are using the bootstrap button component, we have different variant. What is a different variant? Okay, let's try to understand different variant. So which variant button we want to use? Suppose here we are using primary variant. So primary variant. Okay, let's first save it. And then we'll discuss different variant of the bootstrap button. So now start npm start. Okay, now you can check the output. Watch here. This is a bootstrap button. This is not a normal button. If you create normal button, HTML normal button. Okay, we are creating normal button. So how you can create normal button? I'm simply created normal button, not bootstrap button. I'm just writing submit. So this is a normal button. Okay, let's save it and again run it and check the output. Okay, actually this is a bootstrap button. Okay, we are not importing.
Sir, वो index.js में आपने bootstrap import कर दिया है ना, तो कोई भी button create करोगे तो वो bootstrap में जाएगा.
Okay, we are not importing here. Yes. You are saying right. Okay. So this is a bootstrap button. So it look like different from normal button. If you create normal HTML buttons, it's a simple normal button comes with black and white format. But this is a bootstrap button which comes in a different look, in a different looks. So now we are using the bootstrap. Okay. So it means your bootstrap is installed in your system. So now you can say bootstrap is installed in your system. Clear, everybody? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is you got doubt?
रिएक्ट बूटस्ट्रैप और बूटस्ट्रैप दोनों इंस्टॉल करना जरूरी है या कोई एक भी किया तो चलेगा?
कोई भी करो, इससे कोई मतलब नहीं है, ऐसे दोनों में जो मानो वो यूज कर सकते हो ना।
ओके सर।
क्लियर, किसी को डाउट पूछो भाई। हेलो, हेलो, समझ में आया?
यस सर।
चलिए थोड़ी बूटस्ट्रैप की प्रैक्टिस कर लेते हैं। सो आई हैव डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट इन बूटस्ट्रैप्स। सो बूटस्ट्रैप प्रोवाइडेड डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट। ओके, अब बहुत सारे कंपोनेंट इसमें हैं जो बहुत अच्छा लुक एंड फील प्रोवाइड कराते हैं। तो डिजाइनिंग पर्पस के लिए आप क्या यूज करोगे? बूटस्ट्रैप यूज करोगे। ओके, सो बूटस्ट्रैप प्रोवाइड्स नंबर ऑफ डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स, सो यू कैन यूज बूटस्ट्रैप कंपोनेंट। सो जस्ट लाइक अलर्ट्स, सो आई एम ओपनिंग ऑन वेबसाइट, बूटस्ट्रैप वेबसाइट, वॉच हियर, दिस इज अ रिएक्ट बूटस्ट्रैप वेबसाइट, हियर ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स आर अवेलेबल, बूटस्ट्रैप कंपोनेंट, द कंपोनेंट दैट यू वॉन्ट टू यूज, so just click on that component. Suppose I want to use alerts components. So alert component, actually why we are using alert component, are used to provide the feedback message or any user informations. Using alert message you can provide any alerts. So alerts are available in a different length of a text. So these are different version of, so this is a alert component. Alerts components, what are use of alert component bootstrap? Provide contextual feedback message for typical user action with handful for available and flexible alert message. So using alert component, you can provide any message. So actually this is a different variants of the alert. So this is a primary alerts. This is a secondary. This is a success. This is a dangerous variant. Warning that, and info, light and dark. This means total 8. So it means alert is available in 8 different variants. So you can use one of any them. So okay, let's try to understand how we can use alert. Okay, now we open the VS Code. So here we are using app component. In the app component, we are using heading tag. Now we're removing this heading tag and here we are using alert. Bootstrap component alert. Open the alert and now we close the alert. This is the alert. Now within an alert, we are writing what we are writing? App component. This is the app component. So let's here we writing this is app component. Okay, just save it. I'm just using alert. Okay, now we are not using the button. So I'm removing the button. Again, save it. And run it and check the output just. Okay, run it. So watch here, this is a simple test system. So actually, in which variant you want to use, which variant of the alert you want to use. So you have required to specify the variant. So suppose we want to use primary variants, which variant? Primary variant. Okay, we are using one attribute that is a variant, and I'm giving the value as a primary. So, okay, so alert, I'm using variants, variant equal to what variant, which variant we want to use of alert? Primary. Okay, let's save it, again run it, and check the output. So now watch here, this is a alert. Okay, so this is a, which variant we are using? We are using primary variant. So alert is available. Alert, using alert, you can display different types of message. Okay, any textual message, any alert message. And alert is available in a different 8 version. You can use primary alert, your secondary alert, your success alert, your dangerous alert, warning alert, info alert, light alert, and dark alert. So you can use any one of them alert. Okay, so, and now if you want to use in the form of link, so this is the alert, this is the app component alert. Okay, so now we are using the welcome component. Now we open the welcome component. In this welcome component, what is returning? Welcome. So now in place of H1, now we are using alert. Okay, so I'm using alert. So alert, I'm using alert. Okay, first of all, remove it. Okay, I'm using alert, bootstrap alert. Bootstrap alert. So here we're writing, this is a welcome component. This is a welcome component. Now we close the alert. Okay. Now here we require to use variant. Which variant you want to use? So which attribute variant? Variant equal to which variant? Suppose I want to use a success variant. So which variant? We are using success variant. And if you want to display in the link form, so you can use link, alert.link. Okay, let's save it. And the welcome component, what is the problem? Okay, I'm closing the alert.link. Alert.link. Okay, save it, run it, and check the output. So now you can check. This is a welcome component in the form of link. So now welcome component come in the form of link. This is an app component. This is a welcome component. So here we are using the alert, bootstrap, React bootstrap alert. Okay, come back here. And now we want to use some additional text we want to provide. Okay, so let's see how we can provide additional information in the alert. Okay, I'm open the imply component. So in this imply component, okay, I'm display the imply name, address in the tabular form. Okay, so, okay, in the place of imply component, we are open the create component. Okay, I'm open the grid component. So now we open the grid component. Here we are using heading tag. So now here we are using alert. So we are using alert within a parenthesis. After written, we are using within a parenthesis. And within a parenthesis, here we are using alert. Alert. Now close the alert. Close the alert. So we want to give some heading. I want to give the some heading. So if you want to use the heading within an alert, you want to display one first of a heading. So you can display heading also, alert.headings. Watch here. The alert.heading, now close, alert.headings. So now here we give the in the heading, user info, user information, user info. I'm writing in alert headings. And now, After alert heading, now we want to give some body, some text. So you can write some any text. Okay. So you can write any text. Okay. So now we are display this hello. I am just cut this code. Okay. And here we are putting that code in the form of paragraph. Here you are using paragraph. And now close the paragraph. Okay, if user is exist, then we are returning this thing. If user is not exist, then we are returning hello stranger. So now here we are using alert. So now we need to specify which variant you want to use. Variant. So we have 8 different variants. Let's we are using the primary variant. If you want to use secondary variant, you can use secondary variant, any variant. S-E-C-O-N-D-A, secondary variant. Now here we are also using the alert in place of H1. We are using the alert. And now here we are using the variant. Which variant? Suppose we are using danger variant. Okay, let's save it, run it, and now check the output. So now you can save in the grid component. Hello stranger incoming, alert, danger alert. If the user is exist, okay. So suppose if the user is exist, here we create user object, and the user object contains two information. One is the first name, I giving the John, and comma, I'm giving the last name, I'm giving as a John Peter. Okay, let's save it again, run it, check the output. So watch here. So this is the heading user info. Now here we display hello John Peter. So here we are using which component? Alert component. Alert component of React. How we can use alert component of React? Okay. पता है किसी को डाउट? हेलो हेलो
बहुत
सर, समझ में आया नहीं आया
सर? ये अलर्ट है क्या वैसे?
अलर्ट क्या, जैसे H1 क्या होता है
सर? अलर्ट मतलब एक मैसेज का पता था मुझे, ये अलर्ट क्या बस यानी मैसेज शो करने के लिए क्या?
ये अलर्ट तो, वाला अलर्ट नहीं, जावास्क्रिप्ट वाला अलर्ट नहीं, ये बूटस्ट्रैप वाला अलर्ट है। कौन है? अगर आपको कोई इस तरह से अलर्ट मैसेज डिस्प्ले करने हैं बूटस्ट्रैप में, तो अलर्ट वहां पे यूज, कौन सा कंपोनेंट बूटस्ट्रैप का यूज कर सकते हो
सर? जैसे कोई फॉर्म फिल अप करने के बाद जब सबमिट बटन पे क्लिक करते हैं तो उसके बाद आता है कि
वो वाला अलर्ट नहीं है, ये वो वाला अलर्ट नहीं है, ध्यान रखिएगा बोल रहे ना, वो अलर्ट फंक्शन जावास्क्रिप्ट फंक्शन है, वो अलर्ट अलग चीज, वो फंक्शन है। ये अलर्ट है डिजाइनिंग, अगर आप डिजाइनफुल मैसेज देना चाहते हो ना किसी को, कोई इंफॉर्मेशन आप डिस्प्ले करना चाहते हो, वो उसके लिए बूटस्ट्रैप के पास एक अलर्ट कंपोनेंट है।
ओके, जैसे सर एचटीएमएल में,
जैसे इस टाइप के इंफॉर्मेशन देखिए, अरे एचटीएमएल जैसे जैसे ये आपको देना हाय नाइस टू यू है ना, इस तरह से इंफॉर्मेशन दे दिए, तो इस तरह से इंफॉर्मेशन डिस्प्ले करने के लिए आप क्या यूज कर सकते हो? बूटस्ट्रैप अलर्ट यूज कर सकते हो।
ओके सर,
आया समझे? कोई भी मैसेज आपको, कोई भी मैसेज देने हो ना, इस टाइप के मैसेज देने के लिए ना, कभी कभी देखो है ना, तो इस टाइप के मैसेज डिस्प्ले करने के लिए आप क्या कर सकते हो? बूटस्ट्रैप अलर्ट।
अलर्ट
आया कि नहीं आया?
यस सर, समझ में आया।
कोई कंफ्यूजन? बोलो भाई।
नो सर।
हम्म, अब आपको डिजाइनिंग भी बहुत अच्छी अच्छी करनी है, ध्यान रखेगा ये बूट स्ट्रैप यूज करोगे देखो डिजाइनिंग भी बहुत अच्छी बनेगी। यहाँ तक किसी को डाउट
यस
पूछो, डाउट है?
हेलो सर, हेलो सर,
हाँ बोलो
सर वो बूटस्ट्रैप कैसे इंस्टॉल करना है, कैसे चेक करना है, वो सीएसएस फाइल वो सब मतलब वो उसका कुछ देंगे क्या आप मतलब नोट्स में?
हाँ देंगे,
चेक कर। हाँ सर,
देखा नहीं कभी हमने इंस्टॉल किया?
हाँ देखा
देखा
सर,
सर
मतलब
वो समझ में नहीं आया, एक बार देखा
नहीं,
देंगे।
नहीं सर आप बताते उस टाइम पे, लेकिन हम
चलो चलो
करने के लिए जाते हैं ना उस टाइम पे।
दे देंगे, दे देंगे ठीक है, अभी हम दे देंगे, क्लियर? चलिए देखिए अब एक चीज समझाते, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट समझे। सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस मोर अबाउट अलर्ट्स, बूटस्ट्रैप, रिएक्ट बूटस्ट्रैप अलर्ट, रिएक्ट बूट स्ट्रैप अलर्ट। सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस मोर अबाउट अलर्ट बूट स्ट्रैप रिएक्ट। ओके लेट्स ट्राई, हाउ मेनी वेरियंट्स आर अवेलेबल? 8 वेरियंट्स आर अलर्ट अवेलेबल। सो रिएक्ट अलर्ट आर अवेलेबल इन 8 वेरियंट्स। दिस इज अ प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी, सक्सेस, डेंजर्स, वार्निंग, इन्फो एंड लाइट एंड डार्क। I want to display this all 8 alert. So how you can display all alert at a time? Okay, let's before displaying, here we are discussing some things. Suppose in JavaScript we have an array. Suppose I create one array. I have this value 10, 20, 30. Array contains how many value? 3 value. Actually, I want to fetch one by one value and I want to convert this value into the square of number. This means each element of array we want to map to square of its number. So my requirement, we have an array, we want to map each element of the array into the square of its number. So how you can map each element of the array into square of number? You have required to fetch one by one value and you need to find the square of that number. So then you can map each element of an array to its square of number. So this is a approach. But when you are using the array in JavaScript, we have one concept that is a map concept. What is a map? Actually, map function, what does? Actually, map function is used to mapping each element of an array into another form. So in which form you want to convert, in which form you want to map, if you want to map each element of the array into another form, you can use map. So map function, what it will take one function as a parameter. Actually, this function will be executed for each element of the array. This function will be executed for each element of the array. It means each element of this array will be transformed according to this function. And now second, it will take this function. Actually, we are passing one function. That function is responsible to transforming each element of the array behalf on that function. ये आपको मालूम है मैप क्या होता है? एरे जावास्क्रिप्ट का आइडिया है ना? हेलो, एरे क्या होता है?
यस सर,
अगर आइडिया ना हो तो बता दिए, थोड़ा हम बता दें पहले।
सेम डाटा टाइप एलिमेंट्स, कलेक्शन ऑफ सेम डाटा टाइप एलिमेंट।
जावास्क्रिप्ट में एरे कैसे क्रिएट करते हैं, उसका कोई दिक्कत तो नहीं है?
नहीं सर,
कंफर्म ना? ध्यान से समझिएगा, पहले थोड़ा एरे के बारे में आइडिया दे देते हैं, फिर हम आपको बताते हैं क्या? चलिए देखिए,
जावास्क्रिप्ट
मैप क्या करता है। चलो पहले जावास्क्रिप्ट के बारे में थोड़ा देख लेते हैं। ओके, सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस मोर अबाउट रिएक्ट बूटस्ट्रैप अलर्ट, बट बिफोर डिस्कसिंग मोर अबाउट अलर्ट बूटस्ट्रैप वी आर डिस्कसिंग एरे इन जावास्क्रिप्ट। सो हियर वी आर जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड how to create array in JavaScript and how to use. Everyone know array is a collection of similar types value. But in JavaScript, if you want to create an array, you can create array in JavaScript by using two ways. One is a literal way. One is a literal ways. Literal ways. So how you can create literal ways? Using the square bracket. Within a square bracket, if you are placing multiple value, it means you are creating one array. Placing multiple value within an array, it means that you are creating one array. So this is an array. Here we create one array which contain multiple different value. Another, we have second way by using array constructor. Array constructor. So second way, you can create array in JavaScript by using array constructor. Where array equal to new array, and here you can pass different value 10, 20, 30. So this is a second. So we have two ways. One is a literal way. By using literal way, just using the square bracket, and within a square bracket placing the multiple value, that is a means you are creating an array. Okay. Okay, let's we create one component here in src. Go to the src folder. I give the component that is the array component. I give component name is the array component. Array component. Let's I give the array component name, arrayComponent.js. I am creating class-based component import, and we are importing React from React. From React, I'm creating class-based component. Class array component extends which React dot component. So when you creating array, when you are creating class-based component, in class-based component, render is a required value. Yes, render is a required value. So now here we create one array. So first we create one array where I'm creating one array. So let's here we are using keyword let arr equal to, I'm creating one array 10, 20, 30. So this is the array. Okay, I'm not created directly inside here. Okay, let's inside render we're creating this is the array. Inside render function, we are creating this array. Now we want to print this array. So I'm writing console.log and arr. And now we return simple return h1 tag. Here we are using h1 array. And here we are using curly braces and arr. Now we need to export default with the array component. Now save it. Now we have required to use in app component. Now come into the app.js file. In the app.js file, okay, now we are here. In the app component, this is the app component. Welcome component. Here we are using which component? Array component. Array component and close it. Okay, save it. And run it, check the output. So now you can check. This is the array. This is the array 10, 20, 30. Open the developer tool, more tool, and you can check. Go to the console. In the console, we have an array which contains three values, 10, 20, and 30. So this is a way to create an array in JavaScript. You can create little way, or you can use it by using constructor. Okay. So now, once you create an array, suppose I want to map each element of the array to its square of a number. This means what my requirement, we want to map each element of the array into another form, any other form. So for that purpose, we are using map function. So what is the use of map? Actually, map creates a new array. Map function is used to create a new array. Okay, we try to understand what is the use of map. Map in array. What is the use of map function in array? Suppose I have an array. Let's try to understand. I have one array. And this array contains three values. List 1, 2, 3. Suppose we have three values, 1, 2, 3. I want to map each element of the array. So I want to map each element of the array into another form. I want to map each element of an array to its square of a number. What we want to map? We want to map each element of an array by its square of a number. It means we want to create new array. And this array, what contains? This contains the square of each element. 1, what is the square of 2? 4. What is the square of 3? 9. So here we are mapping each element of an array into another form. So whenever you want to map each element of an array into another form, we have required to use map. Okay, let's how we can use the map. So suppose I have an array, we are using creating one array where arr equal to, I have one array 1, 2, 3. Okay, I have this array. Now we want to map this array of each element to its square of a number. So how we can? So we require to use map. Map function actually take what? Map function take a parameter as a function. Map function take as a parameter as a function. Okay, let's understand the syntax first of all. Array, we need to call the map function on a particular array. Map function, watch here, it will take a function as a parameter. It means this, suppose I want to convert arr.map, and now map function converting each element of an array by a specified function. So let's here we pass this function, arrow function, x arrow x into x. So this is the arrow function. This arrow function, what does this arrow function? Take an input as a parameter and it returning the square of a number. So it means each element of an array are mapping behalf on that specified function. So map function take a parameter as a function. This function performing operation on each element of an array. So this function, what does? Is this function converting each element of its square of a number. Okay, let's now we open VS Code, and here we have array component. Okay, so now here we are you converting. So arr dot, here we are using map. Watch here, this map function take as a parameter, as a function parameter. Here we require to pass as a function parameter, and this function are performing on each element of the array. So here, what we are passing? Here we are passing arrow function. So x dot x. And after that, what it will return? Okay, now we are calling this expression inside within a single curly braces. Okay, let's save it, run it, and check the output. So watch here. What is the output we got it? You can check. What is that? 10 square, 100. What is the 20 square? 200. What is the 30 square? 900. This means it will map each element of an array to its square of a number. So here we have facility of mapping each element of an array to its another form by using map. So whenever you want to map each element of an array into another form, then you are required to use map function. So how you can use map on array? On the array, you are required to call the map function, and the map function we are required to pass as a function parameter. And this function actually take receive three value, current value, index, and current array. Current value is means actually it will iterate first one and perform the operation, and it contain the index, current element index position also. Okay, so you can pass a function, or you can define a function. First of all, define the function. Suppose I define the square function. Square function. And now, then you can write the code. So this function what receive current value, suppose it will receive x, and index it will receive index. If you have required, you can, and it will receive array. But it will, what it will return? It will return the current value x into x, square of number. So first you need to define a function, and then after defining the function, you can pass the function name. Or the simple way, you can pass arrow function. There's a very simple format, you can pass arrow function. So this is a way to use the map. Okay, let's here we create new component. Allied component. Okay, I'm displaying here all variant of allied component. So I'm using allied component. Allied component. .js. Okay, so now we want to use all variant of allied component. So here we define allied component as a class based component. So let's, we're defining allied component. So first we import, and then you can define a function based component also if you want. Okay, let's be defining function based component. Function. Okay, I'm defining function, and the function name is allied component. Allied component. This is a function, and this function what return JSX. Okay. But inside the function, first we create one array. So watch here. Here we create one array. This array what contain? This array contain all the variant of the allied. Okay. Now inside this array, we are storing all the variant of the allied. Now we are using the map function. What we are using? Map function. So we are mapping each element of the array. So here we are using map function. Map function receive three parameters. One is a current value. Okay. Current values means variant. Whatever you are receiving, that is a current values means variant. I'm taking one variable variant, comma index, and it receives the index. This is a arrow function, and now open curly braces, close curly braces. Inside this function, we are using the alert. What we are using? Alert. Alert. Bootstrap alert. Now close the alert. Watch here. Now we close the alert. Now we are using bootstrap alert. Now which variant we want to use? So here we require to bind the value. So here we are using the variant. Variant, now value we have required to bind from the array. So array receive the value, whatever current value you are receiving, that value you are binding with variable. Now here we are using key. Now key we are binding with index. Index. Now here we are using some text. What is the text? So this is a alert for which text, for which variant that massive we are populating here. So now here we binding what variant. So this is a JavaScript function, JavaScript component. Now this component what return? This JSX. So watch here we create one JavaScript function. This function what return? JSX. This function take as a inside this function what we are returning. This is a JavaScript function based component. And now here we are creating alert. Here we creating each variant of the alert. Okay. So now we export this export. What we are we are exporting export which component? That is alert component. Alert component. We are exporting default alert component. Alert component. Okay. Now come into the app component. Now inside app component, we are commenting all these components. First of all, actually I'm comment this all code. I comment in some comment. Okay, I'm commenting this code. I'm commenting welcome component also, all this component. Array component also. Okay. After render, now we want to return. What we want to return? We want to return which component? Inside div, we are using the div. Okay, we are using the div tag. Okay, we're returning simple which component? Alert component. Importing the alert component. Now save it. Save it and run it and check the output. Expression statement defined but never used. So what is the problem? Expression statement is alert component.js. Some soon alert component.js. Yes. The function component mapping and returning this JSX. Expression. I am not using an expression statement. I want to use return the arrow function. Okay, that's some issue. Okay, I'm checking the issue. Itna samajh mein aaya pehle kya nahi aaya isko dekhta hu.
हेलो हेलो
सर, ये वाला नहीं है।
हाँ?
नहीं सर।
क्या नहीं, किसमें क्या नहीं है? अरे वाला
नहीं, ये मैप में अपन ने ऐसे कैसे करके,
मैप फंक्शन क्या करता है?
यस सर, मैप फंक्शन फंक्शन के मैप करता है वो फंक्शन अरे की वैल्यूज को।
हाँ, तो फंक्शन क्या करता है, जो फंक्शन मैप के अंदर पास करता है वो तीन पैरामीटर से करता है, करंट वैल्यू और इंडेक्स। एक वेरिएबल ले लिए वेरिएंट, इसमें करंट वैल्यू एरे की आ रही होगी, जो भी एडिटेड हो रही होगी करंट वैल्यू आ रही होगी।
ओके,
मैं उसी करंट वैल्यू को बाइंड कर दिया यहाँ पे।
ओके समझो सर।
इसको थोड़ा टिपिकल लग रहा है, पहले बताइए, जरूरी नहीं है आगे बहुत कुछ भाग है। कठिन लग रहा है
ये मैप वाले जो ये था ना, ये थोड़ा लग रहा था, तो वो अभी समझ में आ रहा है।
ऐसा करो, ठीक है, पहले बूट स्ट्रैप की थोड़ी प्रैक्टिस कर ले, हो ना? चलिए, कठिन लग रहा है इसको भी छोड़ दो, कोई दिक्कत नहीं, ठीक है ना?
यस
बूट स्ट्रैप की थोड़ी सी क्या कर लो
प्रैक्टिस।
बूट स्ट्रैप को यूज करना, बूट स्ट्रैप के डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट होते हैं, जैसे हम लोग आगे जैसे पढ़ते जाएंगे, जैसे जो जो कंपोनेंट जरूरत पड़ेंगे वो हम लोग यूज करते जाएंगे, लेकिन फिर भी बेसिक कंपोनेंट आप यूज करके देख लीजिए। और बूट स्ट्रैप का कंपोनेंट, अब जैसे डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट बनाइए, है ना, उसमें आप जो डिजाइनिंग करोगे बूट स्ट्रैप से करो, क्या करो
बूट स्ट्रैप से,
तो बूट स्ट्रैप से वो डिजाइनिंग कीजिए। तो ये थोड़ी प्रैक्टिस करो, जैसे बूट स्ट्रैप आपका समझ में आ जाए, क्या आ जाए
समझ में,
है ना, कि बूट स्ट्रैप को जैसे अभी HTML का यूज कर रहे थे हम लोग ना, डिजाइनिंग के लिए किसका यूज कर रहे थे?
HTML
का। लेकिन HTML को ना यूज करके हम लोग क्या यूज करेंगे, बोलो भाई?
बूटस्ट्रैप।
और सब लोग बताओ भाई, सब लोग नहीं बोल रहे?
React बूटस्ट्रैप अगर यूज करेंगे,
ठीक है, नहीं आए बात?
यस
भाई सर, वो कौन से कंपोनेंट करने हैं सर?
फिर
आप,
हाँ बोलो
सर। ये अलर्ट कंपोनेंट हम लोग ने फंक्शन बेस पर बनाया था ना, क्लास फंक्शन था ना उसका?
नहीं, अलर्ट एक जैसे HTML में टैग होते हैं।
नो सर, लेकिन ये फंक्शन बेस कंपोनेंट है ना, अलर्ट कंपोनेंट जो आपने बनाया वो।
हाँ, फंक्शन बेस कंपोनेंट।
तो फिर वो app.js है, उसमें तो क्लास लिया है, फिर वो कैसे
क्या हुआ? आप इस कंपोनेंट के अंदर दूसरा कंपोनेंट हम पॉपुलेट करें ना, ये तो मेन कंपोनेंट, ये चाइल्ड कंपोनेंट है। आप चाइल्ड कंपोनेंट चाहे क्लास बेस बनाओ, चाहे फंक्शन बेस बनाओ, कंपोनेंट किसी से बनाओ, ये फंक्शन बेस क्लास बेस कंपोनेंट है, इससे कोई मतलब नहीं।
ओके सर,
समझे, कंपोनेंट आप कैसे बनाइए। ओके
यस,
देखिए थोड़ी सी आप आगे बढ़ने से पहले एक काम करते हैं, पहले थोड़ी सी आप क्या कर लीजिए, प्रैक्टिस कर लीजिए, किसके बूटस्ट्रैप की ना, बूटस्ट्रैप इंस्टॉल कीजिए। हम आपको लिंक भी दे रहे हैं जहाँ पे ये बूटस्ट्रैप की ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट है, ठीक है, जहाँ पे बूटस्ट्रैप के सारे कंपोनेंट दिए हुए हैं। क्या दिए हुए हैं? तो हम लोग जब भी बूटस्ट्रैप कंपोनेंट वहाँ से यूज कर सकते हैं, जब भी जरूरत पड़ेगी। तो देखिए, हम आपको ये URL दे रहे हैं, इस URL को देखिए, इस URL का यूज डेवलपर तक करते हैं, ठीक है, इसी से पूरे डेवलपर भी डिजाइन करते हैं। ये URL अभी हम आपको सेंड करते हैं, यहाँ पे देखिए, ये बूटस्ट्रैप जैसे आप ओपन करोगे, ठीक है, सबसे पहले आएगा गेट स्टार्टेड, आ रहा है, ये रिएक्ट बूटस्ट्रैप URL है, ठीक है, आपके हम उसमें भी भेज देंगे चैट विंडो में, इसी से सारा काम हो जाएगा। अब यहाँ पे गेट स्टार्टेड पे क्लिक करोगे तो ये देखिए बूटस्ट्रैप कैसे इंस्टॉल करना होता है, क्या लिखोगे, npm install react bootstrap, इसके बाद @ के बाद वर्जन लिखते हैं, वर्जन स्पेसिफाई करने की जरूरत नहीं आपको, समझ में आ रहा है?
Yes,
आप बिना वर्जन के ये @ नेक्स्ट नहीं लिखा हुआ है, @5 ये लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है, आप सिर्फ लिखोगे npm install react bootstrap और bootstrap, ये ऑटोमेटिक लेटेस्ट वर्जन इंस्टॉल कर देगा, ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
Okay? उसके बाद देखिए सब दिया है तरीका, अगर आपको यूज करना है किसी भी कंपोनेंट में तो आप इंपोर्ट करके भी यूज कर सकते हो, या फिर CSS फाइल में क्या कर लो, बूटस्ट्रैप को इंपोर्ट कर लो, क्या कर लो, index.js फाइल में, किस फाइल में,
index.js,
index.js फाइल में ये इंपोर्ट स्टेटमेंट लिख दो, जैसे हमने लिखा, देखो index.js ओपन करो, यहाँ पे हमने बूटस्ट्रैप को इंपोर्ट कर लिया, ठीक है।
यस सर,
बात समझ में आ रही कि नहीं आ रही?